The climate crisis, of course, is another global challenge that we have to tackle together. People across the Indo-Pacific are already feeling its catastrophic impact. 70% of the world's natural disasters strike in this region, and over 90 million people in the region were affected by climate-related disasters in 2019. The following year, on our own Pacific coast, California endured 5 of the 6 biggest wildfires in its history. Now, many of the biggest emitters in the region have recognized the need to act urgently, as we saw in the ambitious pledges that they set out at COP26. In Glasgow, 15 Indo-Pacific countries, including Indonesia, signed the Global Methane Pledge to cut emissions by 30% over the next decade. If all the biggest emitters join us, that would do more to reduce warming than taking every ship out of the seas and every plane out of the skies. But you know, it would be a mistake to think about climate only through the prism of threats. Here's why. Every country on the planet has to reduce emissions and prepare for the unavoidable impacts of climate change. And that necessary transformation to new technologies and new industries also offers a once-in-a-generation opportunity to create new, good-paying jobs. We believe that opportunity runs through the Indo-Pacific, and we're already working with our partners to seize it. In the last 5 years alone, the United States has mobilized more than $7 billion in renewable energy investments in the region. As we step up our efforts, we're bringing to bear the unique constellation of partnerships that we built up. Multilateral organizations and advocacy groups, businesses and philanthropies, researchers and technical experts.